wanted to start actually to pick up on this is, you know, I think it's so important when we talk about these issues to talk about real people. So I want to start with Judy Stein. Judy Stein is 63 years old. She has lived in New York City all her life. She is in a wheelchair in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, living on $9,000 a year in Social Security benefits. Her building was recently sold, her rent-subsidized building, and the new landlord in this glorious Williamsburg section of Brooklyn that, as we know, has been a primary area of rezoning in order to, as part of the sitting mayor's plan to increase opportunities for people, has become a real source of, frankly, making housing quite inaffordable for a number of people. Judy Stein now has a landlord that's trying to evict her because the landlord wants $2,100 a month for rent from her. Ricky Padin, if we want to talk about the issues that Sade has already raised, works 80 hours a week at two McDonald's. 80 hours a week. Is this a person who is undeserving? This is important, right? Because when we're talking about these policy issues, what's underneath them is really this notion of who is deserving of support and who is not. And so much of our notion of deservingness has faces. And the faces of a young Latino in New York City is generally not one of them. And Ricky Padin works 80 hours a week in McDonald's, so that's doing everything he's supposed to do. He spends 75% of his income on his apartment. So you tell me how he eats. He skips meals and he steals burgers at McDonald's, which from a health perspective is not something any of us want to encourage.
Or a long-term employment perspective.
So, I mean, so these issues of wages, these issues of health and investment in youth, the three primary causes of this level of housing, so the three primary causes of the inability for most people to make a living in this city: housing costs, child care costs, and health care costs, right? So if a current mayor wants to deal with some of these inequities, we have to deal with these issues. Right. It costs $93,000 a year, according to the Economic Policy Institute, just to meet your basic needs in this city.